Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress Elementor Builder tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Well, we've been looking at the Elementor page builder in our last few videos. It's free and it's pretty good actually. We just threw this quick site together with one of the templates that they had installed there. Let's continue on. This time we're going to build from scratch and see what we can come up with. So let's get a new page going. I think I've got a test page here we can use. Yep, nothing on there. First thing I want to do is make sure it's set to Elementor full width, which it is, and update that. Now I'm going to hit the Elementor Builder button. Now we've got the page loaded. Let's create a new section. We'll work on our hero section. So we're going to hit the little red button there. And let's make it side by side 50-50. Two, there we are. There's one column. There's the second column. And let's put a background in here. So I've just hit the edit section in the middle there. You can use right click to do things as well. Edit section. It's just telling us that. So that's what we want to do here. I'm going to put an image behind there. Let's go to style, background, background type. Normal. Let's put an image in. Hit the plus button here. And let's stick that image in. All right, got that image behind there now. Now let's add something to our first little column here. Well, let's make this a bit wider first. We can do that on the advanced tab with a bit of padding. Just gonna give it 100 everywhere. There we go. And that's giving it 100 pixels all around. Top, right, bottom, and left. You can have it in percentages or M if you prefer. But let's click on this little section here. Let's add an image. Okay, now let's choose our image. I guess we'll put this fella in right here. Got no particular game plan. Okay, yeah. Do with it being a bit larger. We've got it in the middle, that's fine. We give it a border and make it a little more interesting looking. Oh, I see we've got width, max width here, opacity, border type. Let's have a solid border. Let's make it 10 pixels. And blue. Now let's make this, can we make it image rounded? They must have a border radius here, I'm sure. Border radius, here we go, and you can have pixels or percent. If I give it a percentage and give it 50, that'll make it round. That's fine. Not interested in, well, let's try the box shadow. A little bit too much. I'll put a little bit in. There we go. A little bit of box shadow. Blur a bit more. There we go. And the spread's fine. I don't want that any more than that. Okay. Okay, so now we've got our image in there. Let's put something over in this side. We just click on it. It'll bring up our blocks. Or if it doesn't, just hit the little grid icon up here and it'll bring them up. Let's bring up a heading. Make it H1, make it large, even bigger than that. What about large, extra large? There we go. See, our image on the back of this is repeating itself. I don't want it to repeat itself. So let's go on to our main section block. We covered sections in our last video, so you might want to take a look at that. Okay. Yeah. Image, position, default, attachment. You can have it fixed to give it that sort of mock parallax effect there. We slide up and down. Repeat, we don't want it to repeat, but we do want it to actually cover the whole area. So let's say cover there. There we go. Okay, let's make that heading stand out a bit. So I'm just going to click on it to highlight it. Text color, just make that white. It'll stand out nicely. How about we put a cover overlay on this just to make that stand out even more? Yeah, so let's go back, clicking on the edit section button. And let's look at the star background overlay. Let's just put a blue one on there. Overlay. There we go. Let's take that. Yeah. There we go. We can still see the image behind. We've got it overlaid. That's fine. Now let's add something under our heading text here, like a text block. Let's just add this text editor block. I'm just going to plonk it just underneath where that light blue line is right there. And again, star-wise, I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this. We can have it aligned left like it is. Color, again, we're going to go for the white text so it stands out there. That's great. Now, let's add a little call to action button. There's a button right there. Put that under our text there. This time we'll have it aligned centrally. Let's make it a bit bigger. Let's make it large. Oh yeah, I like that better. And give it an icon if we want to. Let's just give it an icon. Something like an arrow to the right or something like that. There we go, something like that. There we go. And color-wise, let's make it blue. Text color, we want to stay white. It's fine. And background color, we'll make blue. There we go. And when it hovers, let's make that background color green. And we'll keep the text color white. Just update that. There we go. Okay, it doesn't look like it updated our hover color there. Let's look text color. We want white. There we go. Text color white. And hover color background green. Let's update that now. That's better. That's doing it. Okay, so we've got the makings of a hero section there. Let's just add this section right here. Let's give it a background color. Even make that text stand out a little bit more. Black. And let's take this opacity down a little bit. There we go. And let's give everything in there a bit of padding. Say 50 pixels all round. So that's going to be an advanced spacing padding. See, we're on pixels, so let's give it 50. There we go. Not sure about Mady Boy's picture. I think that's too small. I think the picture itself was probably too small. So let's add a different one. Let's add this one, I guess. Okay, well, that's even remembered. I'll drop shadow and other settings, which is great. And that picture's more like the size. Let's see what we can do about a bit of padding. I want different ones on top and bottom this time. I'm going to try and make that round. So let's give it 20 on the top and bottom. And let's say 30 on the left and right. Actually, 40. I think that's not quite doing what we want it to do, but it's almost there. It's almost there. Well, that'll do for the time being. So we've got our nice little hero section there. So let's go down and take a look now we've updated. Let's hit the little eye icon there. There we have it. Nice little quick hero section there. Got a bit of a gap here. We want to get rid of that. Not sure why we've got a gap there. Let's inspect it and take a look. I'm just using the Chrome inspector here with Google Chrome. Site contents. Let's got rid of it. Okay, let's just copy this over. And we'll put this in our custom CSS so we don't have that gap. Let's go to our theme customizer. There it is. Appearance, customize. And down at the bottom here, we've got that additional CSS block. That bit of CSS that we copied, let's just paste that in there. Publish that. Now it's published. When we refresh this, it should stay the same. That gap should still not be there. There we go. That's fine. Not sure why we had padding there, but it's easy enough to get rid of with a bit of CSS. So there we have it. There's our little hero section. That was very easy to do with Elementor. So very good. Next time we'll do a little about us section and use some more of those widgets. So I hope you found that useful. If you have, please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, take a look down below. We've got some great free courses as well as some premium courses. Our premium courses have a huge discount for our YouTube subscribers, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.